Hello, I'm Graeme. It's the beginning of December 2011 and this is my video for November. And over the course of the last month, I've had fun practicing a number of things. But for my video, I thought I would do two acoustic songs. The first is Come Up and See Me Make Me Smile by Steve Harley and Cockney Rebel. And I chose that song for no other reason than I really like the song. I thought it'd be good fun to have a go at playing it. The second is a song from Stage 7 of Justin Sandercoe's Beginner Songbook, and that is Wanted Dead or Alive by Bon Jovi. And I chose that because, quite honestly, at the beginning of the month, I just didn't think I'd ever be able to play it. There are lots of challenging little bits in there, so I thought I'd really work hard at it. And during the course of the month, I thought, I think it might be okay. So I've had a go at that. So I'll now play those two songs and a self-critique will follow afterwards.
You've done it all. Nothing left. Yeah.
Well, there you go. That was my attempt at those two songs. Not much to say about Steve Harley. Great fun to play, and it was a really good major chord workout. A couple of years ago, I would have never imagined that I would attempt to play a song that had the big F, the G, and C in it. Switching between those chords, I still find challenging. You know, I fumble them every now and again, but a heck of a lot better than it used to be. So, great chord workout, great fun to play. Wanted Dead or Alive. Now, the irony for me is that when I first started playing that at the beginning of the month, I never thought I'd be able to play that descending D minor riff that is such a key part of the song. I just couldn't do it. And I think one of the, I guess, slightly depressing things about approaching 50 is that it takes an awful lot of repetition now to actually learn something as simple as that. You know, I'm sure that kids in their teens are able to pick something up like that really quickly. It takes 10 times longer, seriously, for me to do that than it would have done, I'm sure, quite a few years ago. The irony, actually, is that when I came to do the video, that didn't really cause me so much of a problem. The two things that did was the hammer onto the A string, and I missed that several times. But above all, my timing was bloody awful. I just really struggled to make it smooth and keep in time with the record. Lesson learned, keep the strumming hand moving at all times. I didn't do it, and that's why my timing was out. Regardless, it was great fun playing it. Fantastic song. And I'm really glad I kept at it and got it as good as I did. So there you go. That was my video for November. Thank you very much for watching, and hopefully I'll see you again in a month's time.